found one in there. I tried to put it in there because I didn't know what else to do with it. Well, they were still winning on it. They were still winning on it. But I'm waiting. They can't help me. They got your best friend. They called it. I think it's the other side of the side. Call them and let them trace her down.
Okay.
If you're just lucky enough to get the right code, you can pull somebody's account.
I was in the...
All the wrinkles are showing. He's not going to hear it.
Norm, you got a hell of a bar filled up there.
Well, listen, How many years have gone by?
You took a rest of what I thought.
That's pretty cute.
Packages, American Greetings, wrapping paper, cards, those
very crazy.
Are you really?
That's what I've been buying it. Oh, I might as well get it while I'm there. So it's all on this order because I've got the agriculture side. They had a big sale.
Christmas right now.
That's how we all got here. We got a map. I guy was.
Attention to Sally Janowick. Is she present here tonight? Is there a Sally here? Where is she?
Set your drink here down if you would. Well,
put the cops on her.
Bar open.
I gotta see this.
Hands up against the bar. Spread your legs, please, ma'am.
Male bikini briefs, perhaps a male G-string.
Hey, watch that.
Can I turn around?
My name's Officer Buzz Goodguy. Better known to you as one of the pigs, that private investigator of G-strings. I'm afraid I'm going to have to hold you for further questioning here. Let me get my notes out here. Let me see what we've got in this case here. You a gold screen color Regency?
No.
In fact, I'm afraid you do, ma'am. Our records show that Pick was seen leaving the Changers nightclub down in Akron last Wednesday night in awful big hurry. A woman matching your description was dressed in a tan trench coat, fake nose and sunglasses, and a bright red wig, and during the all-male review, she dashed up on stage and yanked the G-string off one of the male dancers, leaving him standing there bare naked, and, well, if that wasn't enough, she then tore open her trench coat, revealing nothing underneath, and yelled, here's the pork. Some accusations here. I want you to stand up, everyone can see you here, young lady. Does anyone here know this lady?
No.
And I get anyone to be a character reference?
No.
And I get anyone to post bail for this deviant?
No.
I'm afraid I'm going to have to arrest you on a charge of indecent behavior with intent to create havoc by exposing the bare facts to reveal the naked truth. It's a very serious offense. I'm going to read you your rights right now. You have the right to remain silent. Should you give up that right? Well, honey, you better have some pretty damn interesting to talk about. You also have the right to have an attorney present. Should you not be able to afford an attorney? Well, I got a brother's a CPA. Maybe he can help you.
You understand these brains I just read you?
I've got a couple of them over here. So help me.
Bill, quit, help me.
You understand these brains?
Yeah.
Good. Maybe you can explain them to me then. What I'm going to do now, I'm going to go to my briefcase and I'm going to get your warrant out so we understand each other loud and clear here. What I'd like you to do is to read this part here in the print for me, if you would, please, ma'am.
I have my glasses. Okay, I don't need them, John. February 22nd.
Louder, please, ma'am.
1986. Sally Janowick. All your friends and relatives, relations. Happy 50th birthday.
Very good. Well, feel this woman's a hardened criminal? What do you think?
Hey, Norm, you got a problem.
How's everyone feel about incarceration for her? What do you think? Hard labor?
Absolutely.
Unfortunately for you, Sally, we at the Eastern Onion Peace Corps, that's Peace, P-I-E-C, we don't believe in incarceration or imprisonment, ma'am. We believe in bondage. Can I have your wrist here, please?
Beautiful.
Live it up.
In case you're getting ideas about gunning on me, I'm going to put this jail cap on you now.
I would never live
it. I think she's clearly, I marked her already, don't you? I think she's, we'll know who she is. You know, we don't like people like roaming the streets free. That's right. You look like you're getting a little bit hot under the collar. Fix a little jig there. Anyway, give a blow on that. That'll cool you right there. Tricked you again here, Sally. This is actually a breathalyzer. Whoa. About 3.50 blowout on there. Looks like we got you on a public intoxication charge now. You know what, Sally? I think it's time you started paying some punishment for your crimes.
Oh, yeah.
You know what your punishment is? What? You gotta listen to me sing, okay? I want you to get the full splendor of my voice here, so I want to tell you, I'm gonna sit you down in this chair right here, okay? I want you right there in that chair. Listen, Sally, I don't want you to move. I don't want you to turn around. I want you to stay quiet. Like to know why I am here. It's a very special occasion. It only comes just once a year, and it's not Groundhog Day. Come on in, it's your birthday. So Sally, happy birthday to you.
Oh.
I'd like you to know, ma'am, stand up for me if you would, please. Turn that around. You're kind of a chair here, ma'am. It's like the paddy wagon hasn't arrived yet. What are we going to do, huh?
I'm
going to have to rehabilitate her right here and now myself. I want you to know you're looking at 3 to 5, Sally. All right, with any luck at all, though, I can turn that into 6 to 8, and maybe I can get her off. What do you think? See this key here, Sally? That's the key to your freedom, honey. And I let her use her hands or make her use her teeth to get it. What do you think? I'll tell you what, you're going to need your hands for this next step, really.
Oh, yeah. The golden nugget.
I don't know. She doesn't seem to be taking this whole thing too seriously here, does she? I don't think so. I think we might have to go right into shock probation.
God, you are in trouble now,
boy. Put your hands up, straight up in the air, now. Straight up. Come on. Hold still here.
Take it.
Take it.
it in.
Don't move.
Don't move. Just making sure this is a good bus before I go to... Well, I think it's time to find out if this lady can really... Meditation. You see this guard here in my leg? You're gonna start your fingers down at my ankle. And you work your fingers up my leg, then you come back down with the garter, okay? You got that? Don't go up with the garter. You go up with the garter. It's gonna cost you a little more time. Back down with the garter, right? Back down with the garter. All the way down and off. Very good. Okay, now, why gather up my evidence here? What do you say we all sing her happy birthday?
Happy birthday to you.
Believe me, Sally, I could give you a lot stiffer sentence. I just want you to know everything you saw here tonight, you didn't see. Everything you heard here tonight,
no,
you didn't hear. See, I like to do my work undercovers, and we're going to do a little more undercover work later on tonight. Folks, I'll be back in 20 minutes. This is your notice to appear in court. I've got it here somewhere. There you are. Well, that's for me. Okay, we're off.
She's not in this.
Norm, you go through that again, you're in trouble.
And we for the story.
I didn't expect this. Don't get so close. Well, how quickly you forget.
Not me. You're going to give a speech, give it, and let's get it over.
Boom.
We're not ready yet.
What's that? Hey, Norm, what's that shining back at me? I'm talking about that circle on the back of your head.
That means I'm almost as old as you.
You're getting there. You're getting there.
I can stand in the back.
Bring her on the collar.
Yeah.
Oh, this is worse than the bus.
I have another correction.
You want to hear the
bag? Are we ready?
Yes.
Mary Ann, we have to go to the bathroom.
Yes. I do.
Hi, Happy.
We got the guest in honor off. You ready?
All right.
We're going to have a little fun here for about 20 minutes or so. Maybe longer, maybe shorter. Maybe a half hour. We've never rehearsed this. Don't know what's going to happen. So look out.
First of all, we have a very special presentation to make tonight.
We have a number of them, but
we've already made a few. The first one we'd like to make, by now everyone has guessed that this was a real tribute to probably the finest shopper that Cleveland has ever known. And when we decided that that would be the perfect theme, it was unanimous that that's what we stick with. So, in carrying with that theme, we have a very special presentation. It's the first annual Shopper of the Year Award that we'd like to now present to Sally. And Sally, I'd like for you to come up, please. And Rita, Where's Rita?
We don't know. Call her.
Rita!
Rita went on the
ship. Cut it short.
Come on up here, Sally. Rita Salo would like to make a very special presentation to Sally here.
Oh, look at that award. Look at Sears. Sally.
She don't
shop. You like trophies? You know you love trophies. I bowled with you long enough tonight. You gotta have a trophy every year. We did something a little different. It's a different trophy.
We can't hear you, Rita.
It's a different trophy. It's your whole life. Your whole life. And I'm going to explain it as I go along.
Shopping bag.
This is the almighty with the charge card. As we go down, it reads, Happy 50th Sally, the world's number one shopper. And everyone here knows how true that is. We started off at Grassy's, celebrating, and of course, we're always eating. I thought I'd try and be Sally for one day, and I never did this in my life, but I went to 20 stores in one day. I'll never do it again. We have a $50 bill for her. I don't know if she'll be able to spend that. Try it.
Well,
there's Sally with two shopping bags. I've never seen her without a shopping bag. And as you go down, you'll see a mess. Everything that Sally has ever bought in her life. But don't worry, Norm, she'll probably return it tomorrow. Now, there's a few things in here that are significant. Ever since I've known Sally, she always liked the scrub bucket and mop.
Purses, shoes.
Do with them, but she doesn't them up.
There's an airplane here for all her trips. There's the shoes, and there's a telephone, which she could never live without. And then we have a little fireman's hat, and that kind of represents my husband and myself. We have a toilet here. And I hate to say this, John and Elaine, but that's John and Elaine Rehosa. And we all know that Norm's nickname is Mouse, and we had to put him in here somewhere. We put him in the toilet. There you are, Norm. So, Sally, we hope you treasure this forever. Don't exchange it.
Mouse, you've always been in the toilet. Yeah, cool. Working hard with the job.
Tell thank you, honey, we can go.
Well, thank you. Good night.
John said it'd be short. Great, a beautiful job.
Okay, with that, we have a little skit we're going to do. It's divided into two parts because we need a breather in between. No. The first part is a typical day in the life of Sally Jim. We had fun with this one. Let me set the scene a little bit for you. The table, you have to use your imagination here. There's no dishes on the table, you notice, or anything. This is the Janowick kitchen. Clean.
I know.
Telephone, teacup, morning newspaper.
Overworked and underpaid.
And we have to get the physical props here set up. Just a second. The stars of our show are sitting in front, but also we'd like to present them to you on the slide. They're one of our favorite couple, of course, and they never seem to age. Yeah. And when we get this in focus, you'll see what I mean. Hey! Oh, As I said, the scene that we're about to set up for you is the Janowick household.
Oh my God.
So from there, you'll have to use your imagination. It's the morning. It's been a long day, though.
Go, Michael.
Turn it up.
Sunrise.
That happen normally in a day that Sally goes through with her shopping. We'll show you more of that later in detail, but right now we'd like to just take you through a few minutes, because It's a lot of fun to go with Sally and Elaine shopping. In fact, sometimes they have to stop and play the slot machines before they get going. That's Sally in the middle and Elaine on the left. And from there they scurry around because they have a lot of shopping to do. Here's Sally and her kids and all her family that she buys for. Now, those of you that have shopped with Sally know that when she's gone, she collects a lot of stuff. And oftentimes it's so bad that she has to have a police escort with her. You notice the policeman on the right, Sally and Elaine coming out of Ramsey's. After that, most of us would remember that we've actually run out of something, and Sally's no different. She stops at America. I'm supposed to stall a little bit, so. Sally will shop anywhere, as most of us know. She shops in Cleveland, all over the place, of course, New York, Florida, Las Vegas, and yes, even San Francisco. This is Sally Norm down there in the lower left-hand side. You notice how they're clearing the cable car. Well, you get kind of the picture. Even the Golden Gate Bridge we threw in there, we had to come up with something. Over land and sea, Sally will be there. She'll shop with you. Okay, in a minute, we will see Sally coming back from the 8-hour shopping trip. That's why I had to stall a little bit. My God, she's got to get ready for this. How are we doing, Sally? Okay?
Oh, we're just beginning.
Excuse me, just a minute.
Tell them about the Gucci shoes. Do patent leather shoes really reflect?
Yeah, like
the Gucci shoes.
How's Sally doing back there, Dick? I told you we hadn't rehearsed it. The only thing he told me he hadn't tried on was the pantyhose.
Sally's on her way.
Pantyhose or no pantyhose?
She's always late anyway.
She's running through the floor.
This is your life.
I know it.
We're going to get the hate letter tomorrow. We're going to get the hate call tomorrow.
I will tell you that any resemblance to many people that are in the room, of course, today is totally coincidental. The management and particularly the players take no responsibility for any of that.
Where'd you get the music?
Oh, we had a little fun doing that.
Boy, you have been shopping a long time.
God, Mom, you don't have that much trouble with that.
Hurry up, Sally.
Yeah, this is great. He told me it was going to take a long time, but I didn't know.
He had to slow down for me.
I never really saw it. Really grown in that bra. I've gotten a little bit of
trouble. Don't worry about it. You're doing a good job.
I'm sorry, Sally.
I say, don't worry about it, you're doing a good job. Throttle back, you'll live longer.
Oh, well, Dick helps Sally out.
I think I'll just put these in the living room so Norm don't see them.
Boy, I like your nylons there.
Oh my God! What a team!
My God. The shoes come on.
They fit perfect.
They come on.
Saks Fifth Avenue. I know, but wait a minute. Who's playing this role? Me or you?
Tell us, Sally, it's my life. Tell us it's your life.
Such a deal, I got. Oh, God. I must call my sister. Hi, Ben. How's? Tell him, Ben. Oh, thank you. What took you so long?
I was in the shower.
You should have went shopping with us. Why'd you go to the islands?
We just had a great time.
Deals like you wouldn't believe. Two for one. One for two. What? Take some back.
Where did you go? Where did you go?
Me. Pigby. Sidewalk sales. No, we didn't go to Penny. They didn't have a sale today. That's next week.
How many stars did you hit?
I didn't have my calculator with me.
Did Elaine keep up with you?
She was platinum behind. You know, when those people work full time, it's rough. They just don't know what to do.
Great sales, though, huh?
Oh, my God. Oh, well. Helen, I gotta go because I'm gonna look at my guest before Norm gets home. Yeah, he's out of town.
He's out of town?
Michigan, yeah.
Do you know you want shopping again?
No, I'll tell him when he gets home.
Okay. Thanks for calling. Let me know all about the day.
Okay, we'll see you.
Okay.
Bye-bye.
This is Norm.
Hi, dear. Hi, everyone. Oh, great to see you.
How How's it going?
Pretty good. Boy, a rough day.
Oh, really?
Ah, had a lot of calls. I've been in 5 foundries in 5 different cities in Michigan.
Got
it. Tough day.
Did we make a lot of sales?
Oh, boy, did we. I'm telling you, we hit 5 places, like I said. We handed out 180 knocking sun pins and 72 golf balls. Don't get them all out there.
How's that, Charlie?
Boy, we just had a great day. Where you been?
Oh, I just went shopping here with Elaine, and I went over to Marmontown, and I bought a few things, and nothing much, you know.
Beautiful.
Would you look at this?
Oh, look at this.
Did you have any, a lot of purchases and a lot of exchanges?
No.
I paid cash for one thing. Everything else.
That way we got a lot of cash laying around all the time. That's good.
Want to go out to eat or something?
I was thinking maybe we'd go out to, for dinner or something.
Well, sure, honey. You've had a tough day.
It's all right.
Wait a minute.
8 o'clock?
8 o'clock?
We should have a tough day.
Super.
Super, super.
Norm,
novel. Okay, Grassy's is fine.
Oh, the phone's ringing. Ring.
Oh, hi. Yeah, how you doing? Sorry, I didn't hear it ring there for a minute.
It's Cynthia, the cleaning lady.
What's that? You can't come tomorrow. You can't come in to clean?
Oh, no. Sally will be disappointed.
Sally, you can't come in to clean tomorrow.
Oh, tell her that's all right. I have to return some gifts.
Sally said that's all right. You're going to have a hectic day. She doesn't have to
do that.
Hayes is on tomorrow. Cynthia, she'll see you next week.
That's no problem.
Okay. We'll see you later. Thanks for calling.
Oh, my God.
No problem. God, you look gorgeous, honey.
Oh. Thank you, Norm. You are a gem.
Now, I'm going to get this dude back here.
Okay. Well, after dinner, let's see.
No, that's all right.
We won't.
Good.
Oh, Sally,
if you notice, I'm
Dick is looking real innocent. Just
let me go shopping with them. He don't want to hit
lips. Give him a beer, Dick.
Get two while you're back there.
Okay. We're back to the slideshow again, real quick.
Oh, it's your day.
It's very difficult to cover 6 hours, 8 hours of shopping with Sally. But in about 6 minutes, we're going to try to cover what Sally would do in a typical day when she is shopping, the part you missed a minute ago. We thought we'd give you a little better opportunity to see what her day is really like. And so here we go. On which button?
This
it all started back in Little Poland. Here we have the Polish Import Center. And then it went on from there. The girls at alcohol.
Oh no, she worked there, that's right.
Well, we all know where her heart really lies. 40% to 50% on sale. That's what she loves. Where does she go? Where does she go? Who does she see? We all know Higby. Then it's across the street downtown to the May Company. The Great Northern.
We're going too quick here all of a sudden.
Of course, we all know that if those stores didn't have it, there's many more to choose from. Westgate. And as we saw before, another cash stop.
Refueling stuff.
TJ Maxx and Zares. If all else fails, she'll go to Gold Circle. You know, she loves this next store so much, she's put her son working there almost full time. Marge! Just in case there's a good buy that comes along. My God. We all know she'll shop for anyone, everyone. She loves everyone, and if you need something, she'll get it for you. She particularly loves kids. Children's palace. A dark children's palace. It's getting late in the day over now. Now, if she hasn't found it by this time, cross town to Peachwood Place, one of her favorite places. And in case you hadn't known or didn't know this, one of her favorite places to go, Norm hates to go here, but he grudgingly goes all the time. She has a symbol of this around her neck tonight. Merca's Jewelry Store. One of her favorite places, West 25th. Now, sometimes when she goes there, it's a little tough for Norm. He has to go out and wait, and wait, and wait. Get a breath of fresh air, and the bill's coming. Oh! As if that's not hard enough on Norm. It's across town to Saks Fifth Avenue. And then she has to make another familiar stop after Saks. More cash. They always stop, as you would expect, for breakfast, lunch, interim. So places like Bob Evans, she has to stop in and take that one in. Norm won't take it there. TikTok for ribs for lunch, huh? Great spot. And of course she loves Fridays. Always a party atmosphere. Margaritas? Chi-Chi's. These are some of her favorite spots. Do you know someone, do you always have someone to go to the grocery for you? If you don't, Sally will. Greenie. Westside Market, all the vegetables in the world, love to go there. And if that doesn't make it, on the way home taking or picking up a lane, she'll stop at Stouffer's Frozen Food. Here are some places you won't find Sally, believe it or not. In November and December, the Brown Stadium, you won't find her. September and October, maybe.
Oh,
she used to spend a lot of time at Pine School. Not anymore, they're all grown up. One of the places that gets into her way as far as scheduling is concerned a little bit, St. Richard's. But that's why they have early Saturday Mass, isn't it? When she wants to find Norm, that is when he's in town, she usually looks for him at one of three places. The rec center? On the ice? Off the ice? Sometimes you even find him in the office, knocking son. And finally, Crazy Horse Saloon, of all else fails. I could have put the new era in there. That was nice to you. Also with Wine Hour, not Sally. She has a few favorite spots. The Holiday Inn. Beachwood Marriott, of course, the granddaddy of all. Mother! Well, yeah, I'd be tired. Not Sally, she'd be ready to go.
Here's the star of our show,
Sally Danley. Stand up, Sally.
Nice job, John.
My honor to play Sally.
Good job.
Thanks a lot. We had a lot of fun tonight. But it's not over yet. It's fitting that it's February 22nd. What's February 22nd?
President's Day.
George Washington.
He kept down the cherry tree.
One of them, anyway.
He kept down the cherry tree.
Right. So we thought it would be a special honor to bring someone in very special for this very special occasion.
Are we going to elect a new president?
He's the Yankee Doodle.
I'm
going to
bring that flag on.
Oh. So, in honor of this very special occasion, we now want to present to you the honorable, the one and only, the President of the United States. President Ronald Reagan, would you please stand? Mr. President.
Tell when you wear glasses. Sally M. Janeway. February 22nd, 1986. Whereas Sally M. Baron was born to Mary and Ignatius Baron on February 19th, 1936. And whereas Sally M. Baron grew into a beautiful child, loved by all her family. Whereas Sally M. Baron met one Norman Michael Janwick, liked him, fell in love with him, and whereas on October 16th, 1965, Sally M. Baron wed one Norman Michael Janwick, and on April 6th, 1967, the first son was born. They named him Michael Norman, and whereas on February 18th, 1970, his second son was born. They named him David Thomas. And whereas Sally Ann Janowick, being a good wife, mother that she is, shot for her husband, Norman, and sons, Michael and David. And whereas Sally M. Janwick, being a good daughter, sister to her family, that she is shot for them too. Whereas Sally M. Janwick, being a good friend that she is, to all her friends, shot for them too. And whereas the Cleveland Area Merchants Association, particularly the big company, the big company, DJ Maddox, Marks, and others too numerous to mention, wish to thank you for your continued patronage over the years. And whereas
city of Cleveland and surrounding Cahoga County than any more dedicated shopper be found. And whereas I, Ronald Reagan, President of the United States of America, wish to personally thank you for all of the years you've purchased items made in the USA. I hear proclaim Sally M. Janowitz, world's number one shopper, dated just February 22nd, 1986.
Now we'd like to have a speech from Sally, that's 50, or 39, going on 40.
You know, I'm not going to help
you. Well, you got to get up there. I don't care what you are. Come on.
Okay, why don't you just take a nice picture of her and yours?
Well, we're good.
Sally?
She's good at shop last.
We gotta go in.
Hi, you got it.
Come on.
Why don't you ask her?
What can I say?
What can you say? You want to sing a song?
Yes.
What could... how about happy birthday?
Happy birthday.
50 is nifty. As we said, the norm... Last year, was it? Seems like only yesterday.
Your band's coming.
Oh, boy.
What can I say but thank you to have all my friends, my family, my husband. All I can say is I'm glad you're all here. Thank you very much for being here.
Very nice.
Sally emceeing a show coming from In on a Square.
Starring Norm and Sally.
Norm and Sally. Okay.
Why don't you stand up here? We've got one final thing we want to bring to you here.
Wait, I got to get this wired up.
You already had it wired up once, I thought. Oh.
Excuse me.
Poor Sally.
We thought it only appropriate that
turn around, Sally. You get with this.
And we bring this in an appropriate manner for the theme tonight.
He's going to keep his clothes on. Oh.
We have connections in every. I called them the manager of Gold Circles, and Sally said, come get us.
Sally, do you want to open up those bags back?
I guess I'll be sitting in the hallway next few months.
Open up the bags.
Huh?
Open up the bags. Open up those bags.
Which bag?
Let's see what you bought. Let's see what you bought. Hot air?
Oh, hot air.
You feel like an outcast, Norm?
A little bit.
I know it.
We had to go through an hour and a half of her holding up for us.
I'm glad we're friends. Dean and Mary Ann. Glad.
Don't break the ribbon.
Well, I gotta save all those quotes and all that.
Bye, girl.
What?
Bye,
Yeah.
Call back here, bang, lag, you fall all around.
I know.
Yeah, when you get through looking at it, tell me what it is. Very big.
You like that, Mike? Michael,
you can't take a real deal on it.
It's
the only kind of gold circle.
Is that pretty? Oh, yeah, right. Oh, Bob.
You want to put it on the front?
You guys are quite a writer.
She always wanted her own card.
I know.
Can you speed it up a little bit?
Mistress of the ceremonies.
Why? English bath salt? Smells good.
Anything for me?
Have yourself,
The house isn't clean, you can't.
Oh, I know.
Cynthia didn't make it today.
Fran and Chuck, thank you for the recipe.
Damn what you told me. Well, I think the teacher's going to think
about it. It sure still looks like her, though.
You don't think that is a virginity? You're crazy.
What is it, Sally?
You don't have to go to Mercus. Forget it. Bye, honey.
I can check it right back now.
Hang in? Okay.
Norm, what'd you get for all this?
It's what I'm gonna get. There's Dreamer.
Everybody belly up to the bar one more time.
I can't wait.
Army, you get 1.5 for 30 days.
What?
Thank you very much.
All right. Hey, like a job, two story, man.
Michael, you see anything up for you, right? I
Bailey's Irish Cream. Oh, yes,
again, we're going to quit. What is this? This champagne.
good as mine.
Not bad.
Want some great champagne in the
bathroom? Oh, we got a lot of fun.
Is that a bathtub?
Shower water's down here, so.
And while we got another thing, we gotta go back home for it.
Marlene,
this is your favorite girl.
Marlene. Marlene.
Yeah. Marlene
the drinker. From Alcoa.
Stand up, drinker. Stand up.
Maybe she would like that.
Thank you. All the shot glasses from Alcoa.
I gotta hold my credit card.
No,
Where'd you get that? That terrible love.
Not me, Dave.
My God, is this man a spit?
No, I won't wear out.
I know you're a shop for sale, but they don't make Carquette
things.
There's been extras in the time.
I don't want to touch it all.
Helen and Ben, thank you.
What's she doing? What you got the next?
I didn't read it on.
Here's a
fresh
glass.
Thank
one
you.
One for who?
Can I have your glasses on, Joe?
You can see anything.
Well, if I put it over on the other side of the table, I can read it, you know? My arms aren't long.
Give me a favor. Please,
I can't hear. I can see that for you.
This is from Jimmy. Are they testing it? From my nephew in California. I saw it. I saw it.
We got Dave there.
From my mother.
You're just warm.
And also,
He wanted me to read it.
You got to read it.
How do you like that? Lottery ticket. Log on a cruise.
That's a good idea.
You got to read the card.
I got that at Beachwood Sally shopping. One of my 20 stores that I went to.
Hey, we got anything up there we can use?
Money.
Anything, yeah.
money.
Come on, Sally.
I'm a hard boy. A new master charge card.
From Beth and Bill and Susie. To the Marriott. The night of the Marriott.
Wow.
Sally, you want something real harmless?
Harry,
he was your father, John.
I thought I'd throw that out for
you. You guilty, let him know it goes on and you break the place. It's not worth it, huh?
No.
Aren't you going to give it a word out for the people who came from the furthest distance?
I don't know. I should, right?
You know who that is?
John, how big is that thing?
That's a big shopping cart, you know.
Hey, let's go, Bono. That's only on the first floor. Where'd you get second floor?
How about the basement?
No, it's all right. It was sweet.
What'd you do?
This is from Grandpa Salo.
Who?
Grandpa Salo. Dick's, yeah, father. Dad.
When do we eat?
I'm getting hungry.
Oh, my gosh.
Ameritrust.
We don't have that one.
Well, you've done yet?
That's it for today.
Did you check the mail today?
Wake up, Great Northern. I'm coming early. Let's go eat Sammy's, Watermark. Okay, McDonald's.
What's the name of this company? Bob and Son? Is that right?
Yes.
Huh?
What was that?
You got it, Pat.
I got it, thank you.
Why, what do you have? Charlie gave out Ben's, everybody?
No, I got money for it.
Happy birthday, Ann Sally. Otherwise, the shopper. Design of cover by the shopper, Junior Jill. I'm training her. We all love you.
That's cute. That's real cute.
Who's that from, hon?
Jill. Jill. I'm breaking her in. I take her as my shopping companion.
We'll meet her anywhere, Sal.
You're out at Parmatown one day.
You pooped out a lot of people.
I don't know about the big city, but in our little community at home, we've got people that really go into this shopping thing and they guys and really have winter shop for them.
Yeah, they do around here.
What the hell is going to work?
Why do you have to put them back in now?
I don't know.
We can return it tomorrow.
I would rather
I'll point that card out.
What's that?
It was a scrapbook that a note from put together.
From who? Who's the note from?
From Rose.
Well, read it.
And Albert Murphy. Well, you can read it. It's a scrapbook for Sally to put all of her treasures in.
Oh, go ahead and read it.
All the slide pictures are in there. All the memories.
Here, I'll pass this around.
That was very nice. That's it?
Thank you.
You got all?
What can I say?
Okay, we want to invite everybody next year for 51.
What I want to know is,
this is going to be a yearly ritual.
Dick and John's birthday.
No, Sally.
Meet your primer down, that's yours, John.
There you go.
Thank you for everything. Everything was just lovely.
You're welcome, Sally. I'm glad I could put it in there.
Yeah.
A little bit of extra recognition to John and the Lynn. They did a super, super job in putting Sally's script in. And I'm sure that next year when we're at Grassy's, Sally's got the preferred run. Charlie, where are you at? You're going to pick up the tab for everything next year. Okay, but no, seriously, 50 is great, you know.
It sure is, John.
I don't know, I'm not 50, you know. I mean, I'm not 50 at all, you know. These older people, you know, golden agers, I'm going to apply for Sally's ARP card. That's 50 and over. Special discounts. Stouffer's Hotel. But no, seriously, it was really, really great. Sally, you're the greatest.
Well, what about a speech from Norm now?
Okay.
Yeah. Oh, Norm, you are Norm.
Sally and Norm, yeah, two great.
Thank all of you people for coming to pay a tribute to Sally.
And especially John and Delin,
Rita and Dick, and John and Elaine, and all the others that helped pitch in and keep this a secret. It wasn't easy. It was very trying, and I want to thank my two boys. I put them through a lot of hell.
Do they have names?
And I want to thank John's mother and dad for coming from all the way from Richmond to make a special trip.
Free booze and food, Norm.
And everybody else that came to help make this her day. That's about it all.
Thank you.
Everybody pick up this one. Pick up the other chips. Okay, ready? Go.
See a couple older boys.
Come on, let's go, Mike. Get some matches in there. Because by the time we get these on, I'm sure number one's going to be down.
She's going to set off the smoke alarm.
Get some matches. I know, Sal.
Well, that's all right.
Well, that's all right.
John, your pantyhose. No, they're not. I just got them from the cleaners.
John, your pantyhose is on. No, they're not. I took them off.
Ask that guy in the back.
Yeah, that one guy approaching me. I said, call me tomorrow.
Too tired tonight?
Never on time. Oh, here's two boys. Yeah. Oh, Sally.
Those are the ones for good luck. Hey, Sal, just speak when you're okay.
Oh, one more. Okay, Sal, here you go.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday. Well, I would go from north to south.
He's all right.
He's the last.
I wish.
Look at that diaphragm. Come on. Deep breath.
Coming up.
Here we go.
All right, chill. From the diaphragm. From the diaphragm.
Hey, come to hippies. Here we go.
Diaphragm.
Nine.
Going strong.
My God, Mark, you're coming in.
Light him up against
these.
Norm could blow like that.